It is difficult to pinpoint the beginning of my two-member centennial expedition to the North Pole to commemorate Perry's first successful reach in 1909. Was it the childhood dream to follow in the steps of the Superman who charted the maps of our world? Was it the day the thought entered my mind that to make the Everest of polar expeditions, perhaps the toughest on Earth, could in fact be within my reach?
It's now a great pleasure to welcome Sebastian Copeland, the acclaimed photographer and environmental advocate.
It's clear that there won't be a bicentennial because the ice is just changing so rapidly. It's melting so quickly.
A wilderness that is endangered.
One which is suffering greatly at the hands of climate change.
Welcome to nowhere.
It's like stepping on the moon.
We're here 300 and some nautical miles from the North Pole. We've got about 34 days ahead of us.
At the end of the day, it's a personal journey.
What are you expecting to get out of it as a personal journey?
Some peace. We faced really, really tough traveling conditions.
What happened to the stove?
We had a shortage of food, basically.
We had very reduced visibility because I could hardly see a damn thing.
Well, this pressure ridge is being formed just as we speak. Just the forces of nature, just the tides crumbling these massive pieces of ice.
Hey, 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 lovely day on the Arctic Ocean.
It's good.
Hi, this is Sebastian reporting from the Perry Centennial North Pole Expedition. We're beginning to feel a little fatigued, cut down on our weight by abandoning some of our food, otherwise we're not going to make the pole in time.
Rescue is uncertain.
The North Pole is a very, very difficult journey.
And traveling to there is the hardest trip in the world.
It's tough. Very tough experience.